For 10 years, fear paralyzed Amanda Berry, Gina DeJesus, and Michelle Knight. The three women were kidnapped and held captive inside a Cleveland home.
That fear kept them from ever attempting to escape until one day when Amanda saw an opportunity to run.
Her bravery helped to free everyone, including her daughter, from that home on Seymour Avenue. And now Amanda is helping us here at Fox 8 to find other missing men, women, and children here in Northeast Ohio.
Amanda Berry is here with us now to share more of her life and why she wanted to help others. We're so excited to have you. It's the Fox 8 team. We saw your promo running during the Super Bowl last night, which you did such a great job. So tell everyone at home a little bit about what you're doing with us.
Sure. So we're going to be working on a missing person segment, and we will be working with local law enforcement, with whoever needs our help, missing people. That's what we're here for.
Who could you tell at home, like, certain things people need to be looking out for that's so important?
Oh, my goodness. Just to take a second look at their face. I mean, sometimes just like a quick glance. I mean, you need to know little things about their facial. What was the last thing they were wearing? Those are the most important things,
What have you been doing in the years since you've been free?
Oh, goodness. Catching up on lost time. Having a wonderful time with my family. That's the best part.
It's so good to see your sister, and she's been so wonderful.
So
and I asked her, your sister, last week. I said, do you still go through these mornings where you wake up and just cannot believe that you have your sister? And Amanda, do you go through that too, where you wake up and just can't believe that it's behind you now? And
oh yes, I mean, I still wake up like, is it real? Am I home?
And you're home.
Yeah, so I still get those days to where it's like still surreal. And but then I'm like, I'm here, yay.
Do you have nightmares about your experience on Seymour Avenue?
Maybe sometimes, but not really. I just try to stay positive. If I start going, down the negative path, I try to like switch it around because I'll get stuck there, so. Yeah.
How's your daughter?
She's awesome. Mm. She's happy, healthy.
That's awesome.
Well, she's 11 years old now?
10.
10 years old.
Yeah, double digits.
Oh, wow. That's big. That's awesome.
Now, your mom never gave up looking for you, and you become the advocate for missing children as well. Is that kind of where that stems from?
You know what? It is, because I know how... Well, I think I know how my family struggled when I was gone, and I know that they didn't have much help in the beginning, and they didn't know where to turn to. So I think this would be perfect. You know where to turn to. You have somebody to help you and to maybe help you with the hope, keep the hope.
Do you keep in touch with the other two girls at all these days?
Actually, yeah. Once in a while, me and Gina talk. We're good.
What do you guys talk about, do you?
Oh, we laugh. Yeah. Just silly stuff. We try not to go back, but.
Just keep it moving forward.
So what are some of the things that you're looking forward to doing now?
You know what?
That you're free.
I feel like I'm completely blessed. And I'm so happy that I can be doing this here with you guys. And hopefully finding missing people. I think that's the most important right now. And of course, my family and my daughter. But,
We're so excited to have you with us.
I know, and it's been exciting too, with all the sports teams winning.
You have a book out as well. Huh?
Yes. It's doing pretty good still. It's been.
Was that like therapy to just to get that out of your system? Do you think?
I think it was. I don't know if I wouldn't have talked through the book. I don't know if I ever would have really came out and talked about it. Probably would have been stuck in, that's not good. So. Yeah.
What's been your favorite part over the last couple of years? I heard you went on a cruise.
Oh my gosh, yeah, there's, you know what, the last 2 years I feel like I've lived my life that I've never lived, I kind of push myself now, where before I'm like, I'll sit in the corner, and now I'm like, life is short, so I want to live it, so I mean, the Bahamas was amazing, to get on the cruise ship, those are big things.
When you get on the cruise ship, you always eat too much.
There was food everywhere, it was amazing.
Our viewers are so excited to see you smiling, and I think most importantly, see you living and doing those things that you didn't have a chance to do, and we're so happy that you're sharing all of that with our viewers for them to see right now, and we want to say Amanda picked our colors today.
She did.
So great job, we love the hot
pink. Perfect color, it's our favorite.
So good job. So we, all of us here at Fox 8, so excited to have Amanda with our team and our family here, and so is Northeast Ohio. And Todd is here now with a look at the reaction that we're getting online, and everyone just loves Amanda. And yeah, we're also excited.
When we posted this yesterday on our Facebook page, kind of previewing what was going to be happening, it blew up. And obviously, our viewers are so positive. So we want to share a few comments with you, Amanda, and of course with you, some of the things people have been talking about. A little special plugged in as we talk about that. So here's a Facebook comment from Sharon. Incredible. So nice to see that she's become a victor over being a victim. Congratulations, Amanda. We're all rooting for you. Another comment came in from Court, who says, I'm so happy this woman has such a bright future. She can inspire and help so many people. Good luck, Amanda. And then another one from Debbie, who says, couldn't be happier for Amanda Berry. People will take the time to stop and listen to her and bring awareness to these missing women and these children who are out there. And of course, the Fox 8 segment's going to be airing here in a little bit. And it's great. I mean, and Amanda did such a great job.
Yeah. I heard she was a one-take wonder.
Yeah, you're a pro. You're a pro.
As our, throw that up, sister.
As cameraman John said, you were able to talk better than some of the anchors here. Which is true on occasion.
He said that, yeah.
We have our days.
Are you holding a training for us?
Oh.
Because they were talking about us.
You did a great job.
You are very busy. I mean, you do a lot of work in D.C. too, not just for us. But
in the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children, they've always been very close to me since I've been home, and they helped my family when I was gone. So, yeah. Kudos to them for everything that they do. Yeah. They're awesome.
Yeah. Well, you are taking it to another level for us, because after you guys were found, we were running something every day in every one of our newscasts and helped to find a couple hundred people. But I think now, and one of the viewers said, now people will really take note, and seeing your face doing this, I think, will bring so much more awareness.
I know the other stations are probably jealous right now, but that's okay.
You can't have her.
You're with the best.
Fox 8,
tell
right?
us how much you love us.
I've been watching you only since I was like in middle school, so of course I love you.
That's awesome.
That's great stuff. Well, thank
we
you.
Love you.
And welcome thank you, officially to the Fox 8 News team.
Thank you so much.
We are thrilled.
I'm so happy to be here.
Right. Thank you.
The Fox 8 Missing segment will air weekly on Fox 8 News beginning tonight. Once again, Amanda, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Good luck to you.
And great job.
Okay.
This
You're
is
awesome.
Great.
Awesome. I'm sorry.
No, I was just going to say.
Okay. Go forward. You can say whatever you want.
She's done.
Oh, she's done. All right.
She's got things to do.